Presentation brothers, sisters, members of the PBST, boards of management, staff, parents, pupils past and present, and all members of the presentation family, good afternoon. The last time that I had the pleasure of addressing you was at that very special event in the Goldie Chapel of the Nanonatal Centre when we gathered to celebrate Presentation Day. On that occasion, which was held under the auspices of the LEAF Project, our students facilitated the event. And the highlight, a very memorable part for me, was when Brother Martin interviewed Simon, a sixth year student, Joseph, Cahill and Tighe, past pupils, and he asked them about their involvement in the Edmund Rice camp, in the Lourdes Project, in their training as ministers of the Eucharist, and he also asked them about their experience of living out their faith in the world of today. It was indeed a profound moment for me, and I think for all present, as we were really struck by their honesty, integrity, and willingness to speak so openly about their faith journeys. I hope that faith sustains them in the very strange times that we are living through now. And so that brings me to the present moment. As you're aware, I was appointed principal of Colaiste and Spioraid Naoimh at the beginning of this academic year. And I took on the role with a certain sense of trepidation, but above all else, I felt honoured, excited, and well set to take on the challenge that lay ahead. It is my 26th year in the school, and I have served as three years as deputy principal. One of the first tasks as principal was that I had to undertake was to hand out the leave insert results to the class of 18-19. And I can remember very, very clearly the jubilant scenes in the schoolyard and on the school corridors as the students received their results and were so happy that they had achieved their full potential. And school life, I suppose, started then proper in late August. And alongside the usual hiccups and challenges, there were many moments of glad grace. I'm thinking very especially when we received word that seven of our students had received a very prestigious third level scholarships. One of our students achieved the highest award in our in the Leave Insert in business studies. And we also were very excited and delighted when we did so well in the BT Young Scientist again this year. Our annual readathon, of course, was a huge success, and the monies gathered there, some went to Marymount Hospice and some to, of course, the Presentation Brothers Mission Abroad. Our annual food appeal this year, in aid of the St. Vincent de Paul group, was an enormous success, and that food appeal actually is in its probably 39th if not 40th year in our school. So that was a particularly special event for us this year. So little did I know, or any of us know, that by February 2020 COVID-19 would have struck, and really from that moment all changed utterly. So in literally overnight, I had to begin running the school from home. And thankfully, with advancements in technology, that has been made somewhat possible. Through the use of Google Meets, I can link with the deputy principals, with the board of management, with the Department of Education, with the various management bodies. And through Google Classroom, I can connect with the students as well as staff. So, you know, life has changed, and it is very challenging. It can be quite difficult because we are so used to that personal interaction with each other, with our students in the school. But I suppose, you know, what I am seeing is that everybody has risen to the challenge. But I suppose I am particularly concerned, and I think very, very especially about our leave inserts. And I know that we will all continue to guide and support them in the months ahead. What I have seen and what I have experienced is a huge sense of team over the last couple of weeks. The support that I've received has been incredible. Staff and students have really risen and faced the challenges presented to them and have just, you know, come together and are working really, really well together. The commitment and the dedication of the entire school community has been absolutely commendable. The Trojan work of our IT department has made it possible, of course, for all of this to happen. And so to guarantee that our students receive the best possible teaching at this time through Google Classroom. And our efforts will continue as we await further instructions from the Department of Health and Education. So out of all of this, what is my message of hope? You know, what would I like to share with you? I draw my own strength from the support of family, friends, colleagues, and also from nature. It is ironic that this awful pandemic has struck at a time that is, for me, probably the most wondrous time of the year, the spring. So once again, I will draw on the great writers and poets to help me articulate my feelings about spring and the hope that it brings me. You've all heard of the late John O'Donoghue, the writer and philosopher, and he wrote a very special piece, which I will read to you. He says, "One of the most beautiful transitions in nature is the transition from winter to springtime, when the first innocent, infant-like flowers appear on the earth. One senses nature stirring beneath the frozen surface." There is, he says, a lovely phrase in Gaelic, Ag Borra, and that means that there is a quivering life about to break forth. The wonderful colours and the new life the earth receives makes spring a time of year of great exuberance and hope. Even though these are very strange times, may we experience some of this beauty, the colours and the sounds, the joys of nature. So I'm thinking very specially today of our presentation family, our presentation school communities and friends here and abroad. And I remember in a special way the people who are sick or who have been bereaved. So I will conclude with the words from that lovely reading by Jeremiah that we use for our graduation mass in Colaiste, Brenda. "The Lord God has this to say to you today. I have loved you with an everlasting love, and I am constant in my affection for you. I will build you up, and I will protect you in good times and bad. So be happy and go forth in the dancing of the merrymakers. I have plans in my heart for you, plans for peace, not disaster, plans to give you a future and a reason to hope. I wish you good health at this time. Thank you."